were studying Bond of Love, what the chapter is about? The chapter is about the bond that existed between narrator's wife and Sloth.
Yes.
They were quite fond of each other. Why? Because she was deeply in love with this animal, as the animal was brought to her as a present, and it was very small, young animal when it was brought to her. And finally, it has turned out to be a part of their life, okay, as well as that of family. So how this animal was brought to her? It was the time when the narrator has gone to Mysore, and during that time, in the sugarcane fields, what he has seen, that some of the people or the farmers, they were driving away wild pigs, okay? They were also shooting at them. And at that time, suddenly his friend's eye caught the sight of something black that was running. And of course, what it was a bear. Okay, out of just his wanton need of killing that animal, what he has done, he shot at him, and finally what has happened? The mother was dead, and baby sloth bear, it was separated from his mother. And finally the narrator felt pity for that animal, because this animal was producing sounds, strange sounds, speaking sounds, as it was also crying. So at that moment, the narrator felt pity for that animal. He tried to capture that animal, but it was not so easy to get hold of this animal. He ran after him, and finally, he packed him in a gunny bag and brought to his wife. So when it was brought to his wife, what it was named as?
Bruno.
It was named as Bruno. So this Bruno, the sloth bear, it was well accustomed to the family also, as well as was quite has very friendly relationship with the children of the tenant, as well as the other children in the family. So what does this sloth bear was eating? The animal was eating everything that was available in the house. In the starting, what it was eating, it was being fed only by a small bottle of milk. But later on, as he has grown up, just a month or so, then it was eating all that is available. For example, porridge, wheat, rice, okay, vegetables, food, eggs, bread, whatever is available in the house. But irrespective of adding red chilies or that of chilies and condiments, spices and condiments. And for beverages, what this animal was drinking? Milk, juice, tea, coffee, everything that is available. But this, you can say, this too much of love in the family, it has it has also made the animal it has also made the animal bit, you can say, naughty also. So what was the first instance that we have read about this animal was that
he ate the
yes. So one day the narrator has put what he has put poison. What was that poison? It was barium carbonate. Why it was kept in the library? In order to kill the rats. So this, you can say, after the narrator has gone, as it was lying in a ball on the floor, Bruno has entered the library and consumed it. Okay, soon what happened? He was paralyzed at that very moment. And then what happened? He dragged himself on his thumbs and ultimately reached to the narrator's wife, who immediately called the narrator, and narrator, he has immediately taken to the veterinary doctor. He was unable to describe the complete incident to the doctor, but he has mentioned that he immediately come to know that he has consumed barium carbonate. So the doctor, after consulting some reference book, has come out with the solution of barium carbonate. And then what happened? He has given him 10 cc of hypodermic syringe, okay, of an antidote, but this did not work. And later on, another 10 cc of antidote was given, and little bit, you can say, stabilized condition of the bear, it was seen. And ultimately, then what happened? Yes, finally, after coming back home, the condition was stabilized and it was back to the normal condition, okay, but it was not the only situation when the bear has acted as like that of, you can say, naughtier one. Okay, another incident was the narrator has kept, what he has kept? Engine oil, okay, gallon of engine oil, while he has kept in his car. What was the name of the car? It was Stood Breaker. And why it was kept there?
As a weapon against.
Yes, as a weapon against termites, because he wanted to drive away that, or he wanted to counteract the attack of the termites, okay. So finally this happened, but luckily nothing has happened to this bear. Soon this baby bear, it has gone grown to an enormous size. So all the family members, as well as friends, as well as even the son and the narrator of the wife, they were advising her that this has grown to a big size and this bear need not to be kept at home. So what is to be done? It has to be shifted to some zoo. Finally, a letter was written to the curator of the zoo at Mysore and asked for shifting of this bear. They happily wanted to have this bear in their zoo, and finally they consented, and a lorry was sent with a big cage. And ultimately what happened, that this baby bear, which has grown to a big size, it was finally sent to the zoo. But this only, I told you as earlier, that this was the time when the relationship or the bond was snapped. But after that, nobody was happy, not even the wife and not even the bear. So let us see what happened and how the bear was brought back to home. Okay, so we are going to start from paragraph number 14. Just see. Yes. We all missed him greatly, but in a sense, we were relieved. So they were missing the bear, but you know, they were relieved also. So you know that keeping a pet is not so easy. You have to change your lifestyle according to their needs. You have to be, you can say, conformed to their habits. You should know when they have to be taken out to get them refreshed. Okay. And you need to provide them regular intervals of, you can say, outdoor, you can say, walk. Okay. So ultimately what happened, that this ultimately at some of the point, it takes away your freedom also. This has happened. This is the reason the family was a bit relieved. Okay. Because now they will be able to concentrate upon their own work. Yes. Okay, so ultimately they all miss. No doubt that the bear, he has turned out to be a great family member. They were quite affectionate towards the bear. They loved the bear, but finally what happened? They were relieved also. My wife was inconsolable, but the only person in the family who was being affected most was the wife. She was too affected by this kind of separation that nothing was able to console her. She was inconsolable. Day in and day out, she was crying to meet this bear. She wept and fretted. Okay, fretted means to be angry. Okay, unhappy. Why they have sent this bear to zoo? Okay, she was complaining day and day again that why you have sent the animal to zoo? I can't live without this animal. For the first few days, she would not eat a thing. Yes. So she was inconsolable. She was fretting. For the first few days, she would not eat a thing. Then she wrote a number of letters to the curator. How's Baba? Back came the replies, well, but fretting, he refuses food too. So she was writing number of letters to the curator of the zoo that how's my Baba there? Because later on the name of Bruno, it was changed to Baba because various tricks were shown by Baba. So what were the tricks displayed by Baba? Baba box and bake. Yes. Baba Rastal, Baba Gun, and Baba Bob. Okay. So now these are the various kind of pranks shown by this animal. So when she was writing letter to the curator of the zoo, and finally the answer would come, yes, he's well off. But ultimately what they were also saying, the animal was also fretting, not happy. Okay, and it was also refusing to eat food too. After that, friends visiting Mysore were begged to make a point of going to the zoo and seeing how Baba was getting along. So later on, what happened that she is always requesting the friends, if you are going to Mysore, please pay a visit to the zoo and just see how's my Baba there. Okay, she is often telling to all the family friends. She is always requesting, if anybody is going there, just go to the zoo, check out how's my Baba, is he well, is he eating all the food or not. They reported that he was well, but looked very thin and sad. Naturally, when the animal is not eating anything, it is of course affecting the health of the animal, because the animal also was feeling detached. You know, what the writer wants to display to us, that animals, they too have feelings. Okay, they too have feelings. They are also too deeply attached with the person. Okay, so it is just because of this reason that Baba was not able to eat anything. It has turned out to be very thin also. So the real situation was being delivered to the wife. Okay, she was being told that he is not well and he is ultimately not eating anything, and it is because of this reason it has turned out to be very sad, very thin. And naturally the animal has turned out to be sad also for being detached or for being separated from the real owner. All the keepers at the zoo said he was fretting, and all the keepers at the zoo, they all were complaining that he is always fretting, unhappy, and is always looking sad. For 3 months I managed to restrain means to stop my wife from visiting Mysore. Then she said one day, I must see Baba. Either you take me by car or I will go myself by bus or train. So I took her by car. So for 3 months, again and again, when the narrator's wife was complaining that Baba's not doing well in the zoo, we need to take him back, we need to go to see him. Okay, at that moment, her mind was not prepared that Baba should be brought back to house. But she was always complaining. Yes. So she was always, for 3 months, the narrator was trying to console her wife and was also restraining her. Okay, we will go afterwards. And in this manner, we will go the other day. We will go when we will have holidays. And in this manner, almost 3 months has been passed out. But later on, that was end to her wait. She finally one day said, now I want to see Baba, and either you will take me by car or I will go by train. It means that she was so determined. Okay, she was feeling so lonely, she was feeling so incomplete without that animal, that she wanted to see that animal. And finally what happened? Yes, the narrator took her by car. Okay, friends had conjectured. So what is the meaning of conjectured? Opinion by guessing. That the bear would not recognize her. Friends were saying, you are going after 3 months to the zoo. Bear would not identify you. Would not, you can say, recognize you. But see what happened. I had thought so too. Even the narrator has thought that this would also happen. But what happened? But while she was yet some yards from his cage, Baba saw her and recognized her. But while what happened? When she was some yards away, means some, you can say, at some very short distance, Baba recognized her and he howled with happiness. Howled means the sound produced by the bear. He was producing sounds of showing happiness. She ran up to him, petted him, okay, in this manner, okay, and through the bars, and he stood on his head in delight. Means happiness. she patted him at the back from the bars because there were bars. The animal was in cage. Petted him, and ultimately, because the animals, they understand the, you can say they have sense of touch also. They can recognize your touch. He immediately recognized that this is my, you can say this is my owner. And ultimately, he was so happy that he stood on his head in delight. Means the animal who is always fretting, everyone is complaining. Okay, it is for the first time that this animal was shown in ultimate, you can say, happiness. It was completely in happiness. It was displaying its happiness. And finally, that moment was really a great moment for both the wife as well as that of the bear. And for the next 3 hours, she would not leave that cage. She was sitting near the cage for 3 hours as if her long wish has been completed. She was, you can say, she was waiting to meet that bear. And finally, what has happened? She spent good time with that bear. She gave him tea, lemonade, cakes, ice cream, and whatnot. So she has taken so many things from her house because she knew that my Baba would love all these things. And he's not getting all these things in the zoo. And it is, these are also the things Baba was missing because he's in habit of having all delicious food, okay, which was, you can say, with the other family members they were eating. And it is because of this reason that he wanted that, what he wanted, that this kind of, you can say, that this kind of food to be given to him. But ultimately what has happened, as it was not given to Baba, so it is also one of the reasons that Baba was not feeling happy there. So ultimately when this kind of food was given, he was really relishing it. Okay, he was really enjoying it. Okay, so just a moment, please. Yes. And she has taken all these things along with her. Then closing time came. For 3 hours, she was sitting there. But now the time, there were fixed hours for animals to, okay, for the visitors also to the zoo, during which time they can have a enjoyment time with the animals. But ultimately now it was closing time. And we had to leave. It's but natural that they have to come back. My wife cried bitterly. She was crying bitterly. She was thinking that, no, I should not depart from this animal. I should always be with this animal. Baba cried bitterly. They both were crying. See what kind of, you can say, touching moment it was. Even the hardened curator and the keepers, they felt depressed. Yes, even the curator, who are always very strict with animals, because if they won't be strict, they know that animals would not let them to sit at peace. It is for this reason they were very hardened, showing no feeling, no emotions with that of animals. And you know, in the zoo, animals are never happy. It is not wise, okay, to have animals in cages, to have animals in zoos, okay? Because these animals, they too have feelings. They are just like beings. So this lockdown, when you know that we have to live under these kind of strict conditions, how difficult it was for us to be in a house for 24 hours. And it is not at all possible for us. We were feeling, you were so distressed also, so depressed also, okay? And isolated from others, no connection with the entire world. How difficult the life had come at that moment. Okay, and just imagine. And it is just because of this reason that we should not keep these animals in zoos, okay? And this, at this moment, when they have seen the happiness of the bear as well as the wife, okay? And then ultimately, they also felt depressed. Then now what would happen? As for me, I had reconciled myself to what I knew was going to happen next. But the narrator, he very well knew that now what is going to happen. His wife definitely, she would urge to take this animal to zoo. He was well prepared for this also. "Oh, please, sir," she asked the curator, "may I have my Baba back?" Now she was requesting the curator, "I want my Baba back. I don't want to live without him." Hesitantly, he answered, "You know, they had an animal in the zoo. Now one animal to be deducted from the zoo. Okay, naturally, it will affect there. You can say the visitors also." This is the reason why he was hesitant. He said, "Okay." But what he said, "Ma'am, he belongs to the zoo and is government property now. I cannot give away government property. But if my boss, the superintendent at Bangalore, agrees, certainly you may have him back." But what he said, "Sir," he said, "actually, now he's not taking the responsibility to let this animal, to let this animal go out of the zoo. But he was very much sure to have this animal in the zoo." Okay. He said, "I don't have the authority to let this animal go out of zoo because now this animal, it has turned out to be a government property." Okay. So he said, "You better talk to the superintendent of this zoo who is at Bangalore. If he will agree, then we would not have any objections in letting this animal go out of this zoo." There followed the return journey to Bangalore and a visit to the superintendent's bungalow. Now, finally, coming back home, they did not waste even a single minute.